The following program is an original production of WICC PBS Chicago.
Almost a third of Illinois residents are considered minorities. So why are there so few minority-owned businesses? Tonight, a closer look at a program that partners those businesses with major corporations.
Not even two devastating injuries could silence this award-winning Chicago saxophonist. He's climbing the jazz charts, but still makes time to strike a chord with inner-city kids.
Why did Mayor Emanuel gloss over the city's pressing financial problems in his inaugural address this week? Stay with us for these stories and much more tonight on In the Loop. Good evening, I'm Barbara Pinto.
And I'm Chris Bury. The nation's changing demographics have made some of Chicago's biggest corporations realize the value and the profit of building better relationships with minority businesses.
Today, almost every Fortune 500 company in the country has a supplier diversity program, opening doors to minority-owned firms.
We clean every facility in the state of Illinois for Commonwealth Edison.
James Cabrera runs a multi-million dollar business with nearly 1,000 employees. The company has come a long way from its humble beginnings.
I was a young father at the time with two children, and what we needed was some income. Started cleaning carpets on a residential basis.
Cabrera still cleans carpets, but his client list is now a who's who of Fortune 500 companies, United Airlines, U.S. Bank, and AT&T, among others. Cabrera's success is especially impressive, since only 8% of small businesses are minority-owned in Illinois.
I think when we started, probably was the biggest hurdle that we had to go through, and that was to finance and also acquire contracts.
Today, financial capital and personal contacts remain two of the biggest challenges for all businesses. But for minority business owners, one of the most significant hurdles has been access. Corporate doors, once closed to minority suppliers, are now rolling out the welcome mat for more than altruistic reasons. It's good for the community and good business.
Most companies like BP want to make sure we make a positive economic impact on the communities where we live and work.
Deborah Jennings Johnson is the Senior Director of Supplier Diversity for BP America.
Supplier diversity is not just in the first tier of the supply chain, but it fits into our investment in America because that investment includes creating jobs.
Over the past three decades, BP has expanded its diversity supplier program to 300 minority and women-owned businesses, with $600 million in contracts. Jennings says that corporations see competitive advantages in working with minority suppliers.
And a lot of times we get companies that have a lot of flexibility and they bring us ideas and solutions. And that's really the key to us being very inclusive. Everybody competes. So we do not have a set-aside program. And they're proven that they're worthy of the contract that they're awarded.
Robert Valdez, whose company provides engineering services to BP, says corporate diversity programs create opportunities for minority suppliers, but the pace is slow.
Because it takes a long time to get established and to gain credibility with companies like BP. These are world-class companies that certainly aren't going to entrust their facilities and their plants to someone that they don't trust. So you have to gradually gain that trust.
Retail pharmacy giant Walgreens sees hiring minority contractors as a way to boost the company's bottom line. Rona Forte is the director of supplier diversity. She says the workforce of minority contractors at Walgreens also becomes loyal shoppers.
They are a part of our customer base. That's why it's important, because we can definitely contribute to their economic base, which definitely gives them, you know, additional ways to support our mission of driving revenue to our stores. So we don't want to keep any segment of our population disconnected.
Despite the success of some minority businesses, owners say there is still a lack of diversity on the higher rungs of the corporate ladder.
There's certainly more work to be done. There's no question that an enormous amount of work needs to be done to get to the point where African American, Hispanics, and other minorities have adequate representation in management and boards of directors, and essentially the decision-making roles in industry.
Today we're joined by Sheila Morgan, president of the Chicago Minority Supplier Development Council. Welcome to you, Sheila.
Hi, Barbara. Thank you.
We heard that nearly 30% of Illinois residents are considered minorities, yet only 8% of small businesses are minority-owned. Why the disparity?
You know, Barbara, I think for as long as I can remember, and probably you remember as well, there's been a difference. And I'm not certain why there's a disparity, except that we just simply don't have access. And that needs to change.
When you talk about building a business, I think every business runs against the same hurdles of access and finances. Are there certain challenges that are particular to minority-owned businesses?
There are challenges. To be honest with you, Barbara, what happens is, you know, nobody wants to give up any power, right? So minorities have a particular challenge when they're trying to get access to capital, when they're trying to get access to contracts, when they're just simply trying to get access. Not always because it's intentional discrimination or intentional racism, but sometimes it happens just as a result of people trying to keep power. And so I have found that minority businesses generally working with them has to be very intentional, very deliberate. Contracting opportunities don't just happen by accident. They happen because good companies understand that diversifying their supply base makes a difference to them, makes a difference to their business, makes a difference to these minority businesses, and ultimately makes a difference to our country.
You talk about power. How much of this is about the buying power that minorities now have?
Well, you know what? I think that smart business owners now know and recognize that minorities do have a tremendous amount of buying power. Trillions, not billion, but trillions of dollars really flow through minority individuals. And minority companies really are the ones that are employing minority people. And, you know, it's really a pretty simple formula. You need to be working if you're going to buy stuff, right? And we're a capitalist society, and we need to have everybody participating in the economy of the United States, and especially in Illinois.
We heard in the piece that this is not a set-aside program, but are there incentives for corporations who do business with minority suppliers?
I'm glad that you mentioned that it is not a set-aside program, but instead it's a program to help grow everybody. Yes, there are incentives. I mean, I don't think that anybody gives you money or anything like that. I'm certain that's not the case. But what happens is the incentive is that you can grow your business as well. I know you heard BP, you heard Walgreens, you talked to some of the minority suppliers or heard from some of the minority suppliers themselves. What wasn't necessarily emphasized was how many people they actually employ. And as a result, they shop at Walgreens, right? And so Walgreens grows their coffers. They buy BP gas, and so BP is growing. People are employed in the communities in which those businesses are working and serving, and so it is a multiplier effect. At the end of the day, we're talking about, from a national perspective, over $400 billion of tax income. So when we talk about a state like Illinois that is cash-strapped, right, what happens when we have a large segment of the population that's not contributing to that tax base? When you have minority-owned businesses that are hiring people, that are paying taxes, right, it makes a difference to our economy. And not just our state economy, but our national economy as well.
Is this good business, good public relations, a little bit of both?
It's both. They're not separate and distinct from one another. It absolutely is good business. It's good business for the reasons that I've already said and that you heard in the piece earlier. It helps businesses to grow their business. Minority companies that come to go to work for any business oftentimes bring solutions. There's a problem, and they are able to provide a solution for that problem, in addition to the other things that we talked about. So yes, it's both. It is good for the community. Who doesn't want to see our communities developing and growing? Who does not want to see places where they are serving and working flourish? And so it has both the multiplier effect that it is good for your business, the minority business, and the major corporation, and it is good for the community.
We'll have to leave it there. Sheila, thanks again for your time. Now, here's Chris with some stories making headlines this week.